accused attacker and alleged victim face to face in an Orlando courtroom. The NASA love triangle takes center stage as former astronaut Lisa Nowak takes the stand for the first time. Here's a live look from outside the Orange County courthouse where this major case is causing a controlled chaos. Good afternoon, I'm Gail Pascal Brown. Big stories get big coverage on WESH 2 News. And right now, former astronaut Lisa Marie Nowak is in court, just a few feet from the woman she's accused of attacking in a dark airport parking lot last February. This is the case that's been drawing international attention, and today's hearing had the feel of a major trial. This is video of Nowak and Air Force Captain Colleen Shipman in Orange Circuit Court this morning. Nowak is charged with attempted kidnapping and battery and burglary with assault. WESH 2's Greg Fox is live at the Orange County Courthouse where both women took the stand this morning. Greg, first of all, why is there a hearing today?
Nowak's attorney wants to have the electronic monitoring device that's on her ankle and has been on there for the last 6 months removed. He says there's no need for it. And he also wants to suppress two types of evidence. First of all, the testimony she gave to officers after she was arrested at Orlando International Airport, and also the evidence they found in her car. But it was the ankle monitoring device and the debate around it that had Colleen Shipman, the accuser in this case, revealing a surprise in court. Within minutes of Lisa Marie Nowak taking the stand in this pretrial hearing, she rolled up her pants leg and showed the judge her ankle monitoring device. The satellite tracking device sounds a siren and alerts a company that in turn notifies law enforcement that someone has either removed it or moved to an unauthorized area. In Nowak's case, the court has ordered her to stay out of Brevard County, where her accuser, Air Force Captain Colleen Shipman, lives. Nowak and her attorney claim the device sometimes hurts, is unnecessary, impedes her ability to exercise, and often sounds the siren when the batteries get low, at times putting her at risk while driving.
That's why they might just seem inconvenient in the light of all the media attention. It also creates a problem on either end with regards to raising that attention.
The inconvenience and cost to Ms. Nowak are outweighed by the worry, the apprehension, the fear that Ms. Shipman feels as a crime victim.
Shipman's attorney argued against the removal of Nowak's monitoring device. Minutes later, the defense demanded Shipman take the stand, and the state cried foul.
The only reason he's doing it is to harass the victim.
But the judge gave the okay, calling Shipman to the stand. Immediately, the defense pounced, revealing evidence that Shipman visited Houston, where Nowak lives, four times to visit the man at the center of an apparent love triangle involving both women, former astronaut Bill Ofeline.
I traveled to Texas to visit my boyfriend, where I do feel comfortable and I do feel protected.
But when questioned by the state, Shipman said in Florida, she feels safe only if Nowak has the monitoring device.
When I'm home alone and there's nobody there with me, it is a comfort.
Nowak was arrested February 5th at Orlando International Airport, shown here on surveillance video before she allegedly pepper sprayed and tried to force her way into Shipman's car. Police later found a knife, BB gun, and mallet in Nowak's car. And once again, you're looking at a live view of the defense attorney for Lisa Marie Nowak. She is there to the left. That's going on the 23rd floor of the Orange County Courthouse. And there on the stand right now is Officer Chris Becton, the detective with OPD that arrested Lisa Marie Nowak. Circuit Judge Mark Lubit will not make a decision on any of these motions in the Lisa Marie Nowak case today, but should release a written ruling in the next few days. Nowak's trial is set for exactly 1 month from today, September 24th. Live at the Orange County Courthouse, Greg Fox, WESH 2 News.
Today's hearing is attracting hundreds to otherwise quiet downtown Orlando streets. Behind me is a live look at Chopper 2 at the media circus following this case. Now, I was at the courthouse all morning long, and everywhere you looked, there were journalists.
There is so much media outside the Orange County Courthouse in Orlando, a sea of live trucks, all covering a hearing for former astronaut Lisa Nowak.
Who is sitting behind her in the gallery? Colleen Shipman.
Court TV's cameras are in the courtroom. Correspondent Jean Cazares is giving a play-by-play.
It's amazing. You know, I was hearing on your local television last night, this is one of the largest, most media-frenzied cases to hit Orlando, and it's true. There's media from all over the country, local and national.
It's a major case, clogging up a major thoroughfare for downtown, Orange Avenue. That's where Orlando police have been busy. The special operations unit started just before midnight.
And the media people had already decided to close the lane on their own. We handled it We made sure the lane was marked off safely.
Traffic engineers also came out to beef up the lane closure in front of the courthouse. What happens here in this Orange County courthouse will determine what will happen here in days to come. Will there be a plea bargain or a full trial? Judging from all of this crowd right now, what's going to happen if this case goes to trial?
I think you'll see at least what you've got out here, if not more. And then we may have to look at some other alternatives, because even the one-lane closure on Orange Avenue can be problematic.
But police say they can handle it, including the media, which is covering a woman at the heart of a scandal that's rocked one of the government's most respected agencies.
And now she is facing life in prison.
Here's another look from Chopper 2 Live now above the Orange County Courthouse. WESH 2 is your home for complete coverage on today's Lisa Nowak hearing. You can follow along live and get constant updates on WESH.com.